Welcome to the Real Estate Mortgage Shop Program, where we offer solutions to your real estate and financing scenarios. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage professional. Catch this podcast and more at jogarner.com. Good morning, Memphis, and a wonderful Saturday to our friends across the 50 states. You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I'm your host, Joe Garner, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. And if you're on Twitter, we can pick up your comments and questions at hashtag jogarner. Or if you're listening while we're live Saturday, April the 2nd, 2016, call us in the studio at 901-535-9732 outside the Memphis area, 800-474-9732. Today, our topic is take a little time and save a lot of money on mortgage loans and mortgage insurance. Today, we're going to cover with you some of the most effective places that you can spend that extra few minutes to prepare and compare that those things that will give you the biggest bragging rights on your real estate deal for years to come. Kim Miller of Arch Mortgage Insurance is also going to be sharing some examples of where other home buyers and homeowners have saved significantly on their financing and their home buying simply by taking a few extra moments to consider their options. She's going to tell us about the new Arch Mortgage Insurance RateStar pricing engine that can sock some money into homeowners' pockets and even help lenders and realtors get more loans approved and closed. But in the studio, we have Kim Miller of Arch Mortgage Insurance Company. Kim is passionate about saving deals for her lenders and helping families get to live where they want to raise their families, to be close to jobs, their schools, and loved ones. Kim, tell us a little bit about yourself and what Arch Mortgage Insurance does for their customers.
Good morning, Joe.
Good morning.
How are you? Thanks so much for having me on again today. This is great. So I have a little inside information for your listeners.
And love
if I
it.
Could show. Yeah. So when Joe and I do a little show prep, we get so excited about talking about the myriad of topics we could cover. And we kind of get taken away with stories. And sometimes the stories pull at our heartstrings a little bit. So I'm thinking you should just record those conversations and play them back on the show.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Don't even have to do this. So that's good. So no, thanks for having me. I'm here representing the best mortgage insurance company in the United States, Arch Mortgage Insurance. We are one of seven mortgage insurance providers across the country. And as you mentioned, we have just rolled, at least in the state of Tennessee, in the last 4 weeks, the hottest and the best priced mortgage insurance engine in the country. And we are also doing things aggressively with products, insuring products for Fannie Mae and regular home buyers. And we also have products that we're insuring that maybe fall out of the regular box that we're doing. So really a company that's stepped up and said, hey, we're going to go out and we're going to price aggressively for our borrowers, our good borrowers, and then we're going to help our customers with some products that maybe fall outside of the normal box.
You guys are rocking out there. I'm telling you, you really have the heart of homeowners, realtors, and the lenders backing you on that, going the extra mile. But you know, before we jump into how spending a little extra time can save you lots of money, let's take a moment to reflect where we are in the mortgage market this week. Yesterday, even though the job numbers were strong, they were still close to what was forecasted to be the number. And when the bond market didn't react, then the lenders kind of loosened their ties and lowered the price on these mortgage rates. So Friday's close saw conventional 30-year fixed rates coming in around 3.625 to 3.875. The 15-year rates ranged from around 3 to 3.375, depending on various factors, of course. And then there's the jumbo loans. Those are loans with loan amounts over $417,000. The rates on jumbo loans across the nation have actually dropped quite a bit. Now, some of the fees have gone up across the board. We're seeing that with lenders who are trying to keep their heads above water with all the new regulations. But your government loans, your FHA, your veteran loans, your USDA rural housing loans, they came in with lower rates than even the conventionals this past week. If you want to take a few extra minutes to explore how much money these rates and structures could save you now or over time, you can call me directly if you want to talk more privately after this broadcast. You can reach me at 901-482-0354. That's 901-482-0354. Or you can connect with me at jogarner.com.
So, Joe, we talked about this on the last show, but I just want to get back to it. Our new risk-based pricing model and engine is called RateStar.
Yes.
And it is brilliantly designed to match insurance premiums precisely to the individual credit profile of our borrowers, which results in significant savings and increased buying power. And I'll talk about that in a minute. So, you know, when you're shopping for car insurance, you're asked a lot of questions. You're asked, you know, what is your age? What type of vehicle do you drive? What is your gender? And trust me, as a mother of two teenagers, a boy and a girl, those things matter and they do affect your price. So in a nutshell, the car insurance company is looking at your risk as a driver and they're shooting back to you an insurance premium that matches that risk.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. In the mortgage insurance world, we weren't doing that before.
Uh-huh.
Today we are.
Yes.
So we are doing, for example, if you're a borrower with a high credit score, maybe a low debt to income, you're purchasing a home in the Memphis, Tennessee area, hot area. At Arch MI, you will receive the lowest mortgage insurance premium offered in the country today. So you can use this in two ways. You can use this to actually lower your monthly payment, or you could, with the lower in payment, the lower monthly insurance premiums, you can actually buy more home than you could have before. So it's a win-win either way.
If you're a homeowner, if you're a realtor, and you think about it, take a little extra time, ask your lender if they've checked pricing on Arch Mortgage Insurance, because it can save you considerable amount of money. We have actually seen that in our mortgage office because they do a very smart risk analysis. But U.S. News had an article out the other day reminding us about the well-known commercial that says 15 minutes can save you 15%, you know, blah, blah, blah. The point is that an initial investment in time can save you loads of money. U.S. News goes on to talk about ways that you can take only 1 minute to save 5% to 50% when you're shopping on gift cards granny online. They were actually using examples on that. And then there's Craigslist. I can't tell you how many people, friends of mine, use Craigslist. And how many of our listeners shop out there on Craigslist and or know somebody who's bought what they wanted for 50 to 75% off the retail price? I mean, I'd be happy paying 75% less for something I really want just because I spend a few minutes extra on Craigslist. Well, think how much bigger and more important your mortgage on your home is compared to just like a normal Craigslist item. Would you take a few extra minutes to consider your mortgage options that would affect you for years to come? You know, I would like very much to help you make your plan, work your plan. And if the deal works for you today, we'll do it today. You can email me if you want to talk, ask questions or talk a little bit more at jo@jogarner.com. Or call me directly off the show at 901-482-0354. The most important questions that I'm going to ask you are, what is your maximum comfort level on a house payment? It doesn't matter what the software says. What really matters is what works for you. What is the maximum comfort level on a down payment? We don't want to go over your max comfort level on the house payment. Don't want to go over it on the down payment. How long do you plan on keeping this house? The questions help us get to the right loan products at the right price, and it only takes a few minutes.
So, Joe, you've got the hard job. You've got the job of actually putting them in the correct mortgage, and you do it well, and you do it beautifully. My job is easy. I just have a couple of options. We've got monthly mortgage insurance, or we've got single paid. And you're talking about planning. If you choose the monthly option, then the loan doesn't require to have mortgage insurance forever. You can plan on that dropping off when your loan reaches a 78% loan-to-value, or if you know that your property value is increased and your loan-to-value is 80% or below, just ask your lender. Drop it.
Absolutely. Well, you know, we're talking about take a little time, save a lot of money on your mortgage loans and mortgage insurance. We want to talk with you. Whatever questions you have, you can call us while we're live on the air. That's Saturday, April 2nd, 2016 at 901-535-9732. We got some mortgage stuff coming up. We'll see you guys back in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Joe Rojas with the lead team of Fertley Martin & McDonald in Memphis, Tennessee. You're listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. Now back to your host, Joe Garner.
And you're back on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I am Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can find me at jogarner.com. You can also find me at Evolve Bank and Trust. We're talking with Kim Miller of Arch Mortgage Insurance, and we're talking about take a little time, save a lot of money on your mortgage loans and your mortgage insurance. And we're going to take a little time. Well, if I tell you what, we're going to take a little time and we're going to talk to Terry Murphy. I saw Terry Murphy just called into the show. Terry Murphy is a real estate and lending coach. And Terry, it's great to have you on the line. How can we help you today?
Well, good morning, Miss Joe. How's it going over there?
Hey, I got a question for you. I actually asked Terry last night. I was on her Facebook blowing it up saying, hey, Terry, if there's one priority that you give your clients where they would spend their extra time to save the most money, where do you tell your clients to do that, Terry?
Well, I got to tell you, I thought about that long and hard. And, you know, there's so many areas that a buyer needs to have consciousness. And so much of the time, it depends on their team, which is the lender, which is you, and the guidance and the expertise they get on that end, and then the expertise and the guidance they get from their agent. And most of them don't understand that they need to interview both, right?
Right.
So if it were me, the first thing I would do is say, if I'm a buyer, yeah, you can do all the homework you want on the internet. You can look at houses till you're blue in the face. But you won't know some of the local and hyper-local issues that you may want to be aware of. So obviously the first step is they've got to be pre-approved, not pre-qualified. I'm sure you've covered that.
Well, we haven't yet, but we just did. You want to know that you're going to qualify for the loan that you're going to need to get the house that you want. And you want to know that before you go out and start looking at properties.
Number one, yeah. And of course, we know that there's a big difference between pre-qualified and pre-approved. And with the new TRID regulation timeline, a good realtor and a good loan originator collaboration will help the buyer understand the importance of getting all of what they need so that they meet those guidelines.
Very good point. So the extra time you spend to save lots of money, first of all, you need to visit with your lender, somebody who really cares about you, who will ask the more detailed questions to determine what you qualify for and how to get it where you get the house that you want. You need to have that conversation with the lender. You need to have a conversation once you have that pre-approval status with a realtor. And Terry, what I'm hearing you say is that a good realtor will help you drill into the hyper detail of that market.
Well, think about it. There's a number of things. No disrespect to the mega people like Zillow and Trulia, but there are statistical information I would want to know. So let's just say you've been transferred here with international paper, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And instead of just going, we're looking for a 4-bedroom, 2.5-bath, blah, 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 in a good school district, whatever that means, then I want to know what's the percentage of turnover? Because if I'm only going to be here 3 to 5 years, I want to know, of the 1,180 properties, is there a 13% turnover, a 10%, or a 0% if I have to sell that house?
Right.
I want to know the traffic pattern. If it's a cul-de-sac development and there's a high school 2 blocks away, is it a jam up at 3:00 in the afternoon?
Yes.
If I'm buying a condo, what are the limitations? I mean, I've watched people go all the way to the end only to find out their dog was 65 pounds and the limit was 40.
No.
Oops.
Yeah.
You know, you're right, Terry. And Terry, tell us a little bit about how we contact you. Terry is a super good real estate coach and real estate lender. She has helped me tremendously. How do we contact you?
Well, it's pretty simple. You can just go to my, you can email me, of course, at Terry, and that's T-E-R-R-I, at terrymurphy.com. Or you can simply call Jo Garner, and she'll get a hold of me. It's just great.
A free plug. We love you, Terry. Thank you for hanging out with us on Real Estate Mortgage Shop.
Let's do a whole show on the biggest mistakes you can make in marriage and in buying real estate.
Hey, we'd need more than 1 hour. Thank you, Terry.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. We've got Pat Goldstein on the line. Pat Goldstein, the gold standard in real estate with Cry Like, right here in Memphis. Pat, how can we help you today? Or how can you help us? I know I called her last night and I said, hey, Pat, we're talking about take a little time, save a lot of money on your mortgage loans and your mortgage insurance. Pat, what is the number one of the number one things you tell your clients on where to spend some extra time to save themselves a lot of money?
Well, as you know, Jo, I have a long list of things
Yes.
that I will help them with. But one of the things that they really need to do, and not too many people get around to it, is reading the contract before they sit down to make an offer. The contract, without all of the addenda, is now 10 pages long. And it's very small print, and it was written by attorneys. So you can imagine how complex it can get. If you sit down to write an offer when you're excited and you really want the house and you just want to get all of this over with so that you can get your house, you may not pay attention to some of the fine details that are really important.
Mm-hmm. That's a very good point. And, Pat, I know you have a long list. Pat's been on Real Estate Mortgage Shop numerous times, and Pat is a financial supporter of Talk Shop, which offers free education and networking for anyone interested in real estate or business. So we get a lot of good wisdom from you, Pat, at Talk Shop and in different organizations around the city. So I just want to thank you, and thank you for calling Real Estate Mortgage Shop and offering one of your many tips.
You're welcome.
How do we contact you?
Oh, okay. My number is 901-606-2000.
Gracias. Thank you so much for being on the show with us, Pat. Going back to your question, I wanted you to cover real quick, Kim. We're talking about mortgage insurance, and a lot of people out there who are not every day in the real estate business may not know what is mortgage insurance and what does it do and what does it not do.
Yeah, so back in the old days, and those were great tips, by the way. I love that.
Yes.
Back in the old days, I'll say it was 20% down to buy a house.
Mm-hmm.
So that limited the number of people that actually could. So to increase home ownership, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac mandated that you can put 5% down or 3%, even as little as 3% down, 10% down, but you're going to need to have some insurance. And I think I want to debunk the myth a little bit that this MI is evil, because MI actually protects the
mortgage
lender.
Insurance,
yeah. Yep, mortgage insurance protects the lender in case the borrower defaults on the loan, right?
Mm-hmm. Doesn't protect the borrower, protects the lender.
So it's appeared, it's deemed to be ugly by the borrowers, but mm-hmm. it actually allows them to buy a house sooner than they could before, you know, without
good
saving
point.
20% down. So
yes.
it is a good thing. It is not an evil thing. And so the agencies required, the agencies set the levels of coverage, which dictate the price.
Mm-hmm.
And
agencies meaning like Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, FHA.
Correct. Exactly. Mm-hmm. So that's the genesis, if you will, of mortgage insurance and why it's important. We all know how important home ownership is to society as a whole and to the individual into the family. So it's a good thing.
It is a good thing. It leaves the money in your pocket for emergencies, for other things you like to do, like eat and go on vacation every now and then, and, you know, things like that. And the other thing too, Kim, is that mortgage insurance is usually, if you do it monthly, it's fixed. And whereas if you're trying to get money from an adjustable rate place, you know, like you're like a line of credit or something, that money has got an interest rate risk on it. So you avoid a lot of interest rate risk when you can get locked in on a private mortgage insurance low rate. And of course, private mortgage insurance on conventional loans typically goes away once you get to a 78% loan to value. But talk real quick about the types of mortgage insurance. A lot of people don't realize that it's not just monthly. You could choose to have your lender or your seller or yourself pay a one-time lump sum and not have any mortgage insurance per month and still get into the house for 5% to 10% down.
Yeah, it's very simple. There are really kind of a couple of options that we do. About 98% of the mortgage insurance in the U.S., you have a monthly option, and you have a single premium option. And what that means, you can opt to pay for your mortgage insurance monthly with each monthly mortgage insurance payment. Mm-hmm. Or you could choose to either, as a borrower, pay for the full term, the insurance that would cover the life of the loan up front. Mm-hmm. You could negotiate for seller to pay that, or you could actually finance it into your loan. But there you are paying for the mortgage insurance for the life of the loan.
Right.
Let's assume that you're going to be there for 30 years and you're not moving. Mm-hmm. A better option sometimes, and particularly with our lower pricing that we're offering, is let's say you're going to be in the home for 3 to 5 years. Mm-hmm. You might want to look at the monthly option.
Right.
It's low, it's monthly, and hey, if you do stay there longer and you do reach your loan to value of 80%, it will go away, whereas the single premium, you've paid for it. So let's say you paid for it for the life of loan, but you live there for 2 years, you've really spent money you didn't need to spend.
Right. And in different cases, and this one, it comes down to getting a lender who will really listen and really drill into your specific situation and tailor that mortgage terms to you.
Exactly.
And not just a one-size-fits-all. Mortgages are not one-size-fits-all, believe me. And I'd love to talk with you. You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop, and I'm Joe Garner, Mortgage Loan Officer. I'm your host. You can reach me at jogarner.com. You can also email me at jo@jogarner.com. Kim, how do we reach you with Arch Mortgage Insurance?
Sure, you can go to our site, www.archmi.com. And if you want to reach me individually, 615-424-1500.
And we want to talk with you guys out there, so call us while we're live in the studio, 901-535-9732. We'll see you guys back in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Tom King from Bill King Appraisal Company in Memphis, Tennessee, and you're listening to The Real Estate Mortgage Shop. And now, back to your host, Joe Garner.
Give me just a little more time, and I'll surely grow.
Give me just a little more time to save me a lot more money. Take a little time, save a lot of money on your mortgage loans and your mortgage insurance. You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop, and I'm your host, Joe Garner, Mortgage Loan Officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. You can also call me directly off the air at 901-482-0354. And we're talking with Kim Miller of Arch Mortgage Insurance, and we're talking about take a little time, save a lot of money. We want you to take a little time and talk with us on the air, so you can call us while we're live in the studio at 901-535-9732. And Ellen took us up on our offer to call. So, Ellen, glad to have you on the show. How can we help you today?
Yes, thank you. Our son bought a house last year in a kind of an appreciating area of Nashville, and they got hit with the first-time home buyers, and they got hit with a pretty big mortgage insurance.
Mm-hmm.
Their income has doubled since last year, and they've made some improvements on the home. And he just wanted to – he called me about 2 weeks ago and said, how can we get this mortgage insurance off?
That's a great question. So let me ask you a question. They purchased the home. How much did they put down originally on the home? Was it five?
I think they put down probably about 10%.
10%. So, and Nashville's a hot market. And what they can do, they can reach out to their existing mortgage provider, and they can inquire about removing that mortgage insurance if they have done some improvements to the property and it has appreciated, and perhaps the loan to value is now at 80%. The lender may, after kind of looking at their payment history and looking at perhaps an appraisal of the property, they may opt to drop that mortgage insurance.
Okay, so it's based on directly with your mortgage.
Yeah, get directly with your mortgage lender. You can also, you know, I don't know when they purchased it. I don't know what their existing rate is, but there's always an option to refinance that into a new loan with maybe a better rate and a lower mortgage insurance, some of the lower rates that we're offering. So a couple of options. You really have to get a good feel of what the value is in the marketplace. And then if it's not reached the 80%, then you might want to look at refinancing that.
Is it a conventional or FHA loan, Ellen?
It's conventional.
That's good.
Yeah, 10% down.
Because FHA is not very flexible on getting rid of it sooner, but conventional is, as Kim was talking about. Ellen, we appreciate you calling. I hope you leave your name and your number with our producer so that Kim can get back with you and drill in a little bit more on how to help your son get rid of this mortgage insurance.
Yeah, thanks for the question, Ellen.
Thanks.
We appreciate you. We've got Kevin on the line, and she's like me. She has a male name, and we have lots of funny stories because we have a male name. My name's Joe, and I'm a woman, and this lady's name is Kevin, so we've shared many. But anyway, Kevin is with Crylike. She also runs the Success School of Real Estate, and I asked her to call to talk to us about what is the number one area, one of the number one areas that you share with your clients on where to spend their time to save the most money, Kevin.
Hey, Joe, it's nice to talk to you guys today. I'm going to parrot pretty much everything everybody else has said. The very first thing that I tell my buyers is we have got to get you to a lender. We've got to have a real hard credit check done to find out what's going on with your credit, not just the consumer going to myfico.com and that kind of thing, but we have to get to a lender and find out what they can afford. The other thing that I have them do is make a list of five must-haves in the real estate that they're going to be looking for so that we don't spend a lot of time running around looking at things that are not really what they are ultimately going to be buying. And what happens is that the buyers get distracted. The more they look, the more confused they become. So we get our loan in place. We have a list of five things they must have. And when I write that offer on their behalf, we've got a letter from a lender that says they have gone through the preliminary qualifications to qualify for a loan, and that is...
That's great. That's great information, Kevin. You know, I hope that you've also... I've got your number, so I'm going to have some information from Kevin on the blog. And, Kevin, if you can shoot me an email with some of the other tips that you have, we can put it on the blog there. We'll put your information where people can call you directly. And I want to thank Kevin because she's on vacation and she called us from out of town. So
I'm out here in the sticks. I don't even have a computer.
You are.
I'm talking to you guys.
Well, we love you for it. We thank you for calling, Kevin. And please do send me those other points you're going to make. I will include them on the blog so that we'll have them for our listeners who want to check out a little further.
So, Joe, I have a question for you. So, can you give some examples of clients who took the time to consider and compare loan programs?
You know, that's a great question. And I had one particular client just the other day that said she kept hearing me on the radio saying, trying to decide to buy or rent, either way, you're going to make a mortgage payment, yours or your landlord's. I say that all the time. Their rent had steadily been going up, and she took a little time to look at the areas where real estate values seemed to be going up, and she called me and she said, you know what, I'm tired of making my landlord's mortgage payment. It's time for me to build something for me. And her house payment was actually, when we ended up doing the loan for her to buy her house, her payment was lower, and the house was bigger than where she was renting. And now she makes her house note, and when she does, she knows that part of it goes to pay down the mortgage, and she's building value for her and not somebody else. You know, another one that's really popular, parents have called me. They've got their kids are going to college, and instead of just gritting their teeth and paying for that student housing near the campus, they've taken some extra time. They've called their realtor. They've called me. And we have found some of these parents a very nice investment, some great terms on investment that keeps giving back month after month because their kids are living in a house that is owned by their parents, or in some cases, we put the children on there too. And they rent out some of the rooms to their fellow students, and they're actually making money instead of spending money on that housing. That's thinking outside the box, and can bring you wealth and prosperity. The other thing, take a few minutes to talk to your lender. I would love to be that lender that you talk to explore some different terms for your specific situation. It is amazing I ask my clients questions that other lenders at these 1-800 numbers do not ask you. And in the course of doing that, we're able to tweak a mortgage insurance product, save you, you know, $80 a month in some cases. I had one the other day where we saved them quite a bit of money. It was a little right under $100 a month just by asking one little question and going with Arch instead of going with another mortgage insurance. Just the little thing. Spend the extra time. Make a lot of money.
Great, Joe. So I can ask you another question?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Could you share some results from some of your realtor opinions on where the best places for their clients to spend extra time to save more money?
Well, you know, and I'm glad you asked that because I want you guys to go to the blog on this show, Take a Little Extra Time, Save a Lot of Money blog post on jogarner.com. We heard from Terry Murphy. We've heard from Kevin Figg, Pat Goldstein on things that they tell their clients to do to save the most money, spend a little extra time. So that is at jogarner.com. You'll find the blog post called Take a Little Time, Save a Lot of Money. You know, Kim, this time just flies.
No, I have so much
more.
And
I've got
a
question to ask you real quick. I wanted to ask you to give some examples of where you've been able to save a deal or save money for a lender, a realtor, and that home buyer.
Yeah, so can I do that with a story?
Yeah, you can tell. I love stories.
It's my favorite. Okay, so this is a true story. So my job is just to go around and spread the good news of these lower rates. So I'm in a loan officer's office the other day, and he was bummed out because he had a lady, a divorced single mother of two, who he had just turned down for a loan, a conventional loan, 5% down. She received child support from her husband, but she didn't receive it regularly enough for it to be qualifying income. Uh-huh. So they couldn't use it. So she was unable to get the house that she wanted in the area of town that she wanted for educational purposes. We ran a rate. We got the DTI down, the debt to income ratio down with our new rate. It was actually $34 or less a month than the rate that they had quoted from another provider. We were able to get the loan
Yay.
Approved in the house that she wanted, Yay. In the area that she wanted, without having to use that income for qualifying purposes. That is a win.
That's why you're passionate about what you do, Kim.
Exactly. That makes a difference.
If you guys could see this lady, she comes in at 8 o'clock on a Saturday morning, and she is pumped. She is ready to talk. That's being passionate about what you do.
That's good stuff.
You know, we've got about a minute and a half. You've got plenty of stories. We had coffee this morning at 8 o'clock, and she was telling me some that just got me so excited as a lender because, you know, I don't get paid till the loan closes. But most importantly, I love happy customers. We go to closing, and they're like, you know what, Joe? We went to another lender, and they couldn't get this done, and you did. And we just want to say how much we appreciate you getting us in our house where our child can go to the school that they want to go to. They can live across the street from grandma and our loved ones. Tell another story of how you've saved a deal.
So these are along the same lines, but this is another story of a customer, and the borrowers had 766 credit scores, but their debt to income was a little high at 46%. So the lender had an overlay that wouldn't let them do that regular convention financing. Mm-hmm. They would have to take that FHA. But the borrowers had 5% to put down, but the FHA would put them into the upfront mortgage insurance premium. It would put them into higher monthly. It just wasn't a place to be. So we actually went in and ran a rate with a credit score. Our rate was $28 less a month. It put their debt to income down to 43%, and he was able to keep that borrower
Yay.
In a conventional loan.
I love it. We're getting ready to go to break, but we've got Phyllis and we've got Lynn on the line, and I'm going to ask Phyllis and Lynn if they can hold on. I'm going to talk to you really quick during the break. You're on Real Estate, and then we'll get you on the air. You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I'm Joe Garner, Mortgage Loan Officer. You connect with me at jogarner.com. We're talking with Kim Miller of Arch Mortgage Insurance. We want to talk with you. Give us a call in the studio, 901-535-9732.
Hi, I'm David Lenore, Shelby County Trustee. You're listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. Now back to your host, Joe Garner.
And it's that time. You're back on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I am Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. You can connect with me by email if you'd like, jo at jogarner.com or at 901-482-0354. I would love to talk with you. I'd love to help you make your plan, work your plan, and if that deal works for you today, we'll do it today. We're also talking with Kim Miller of Arch Mortgage. Kim, how do we reach you?
Hi, you can reach me by calling 615-424-1500, or my email address is kmiller@archmi.com.
That's very easy to remember. We're talking about take a little time, save a lot of money on mortgage loans and mortgage insurance, and we've got Phyllis on the line. Phyllis, thank you so much for listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. How can we help you today?
Well, yes, ma'am. I was inquiring about, I have 2 years left on my home, and you all was talking about the homeowner's insurance. Mm-hmm. I was wondering, after I pay my home off, do I keep my existing homeowner's insurance?
Absolutely. You always want to keep the homeowner's insurance because that protects your home and often the contents of your home. So you always want to keep your homeowner's insurance.
Okay, so that's the best thing that I need to do because, like I say, I have 2 years left on my home. And so let me ask you this question here.
Sure.
Okay, I pay it monthly. It's included in my mortgage note.
That's great. Right.
But after my home is paid off, so I get in contact with my homeowner's insurance, and because I would like to pay it yearly.
Yes, you can do that, and Ms. Phyllis, you can definitely do that. But homeowner's insurance and private mortgage insurance, like Kim sells, are two different things. The private mortgage insurance covers the lender in case of default, and it allows that home buyer to get into the deal for a lot less money down.
Okay.
But homeowner's insurance is going to cover you in case of fire or theft or things like that. And once your house is paid off and that mortgage is paid, you definitely want to get with your lender, your insurance agent, and see about paying that on your own.
Okay. That's what I wanted to know.
Well, congratulations on getting your mortgage paid off soon.
That's what
Phyllis.
I was going to say. Yeah,
kudos
congratulations.
To you. We appreciate Phyllis being on the line. We've got Lynn McDonald on the line. And Lynn, how can we help you today?
Well, I just happen to be a homeowner insurance agent, and a tip to Phyllis is
perfect
it's
timing.
Actually cheaper if you pay annually. So definitely have her contact her company. But when we have a success story and save the customer significant money by giving them a better homeowner quote, I'm always asked, when can I get my mortgage company to recognize this? Do I have to wait until the annual renewal of my loan, you know, the anniversary date, or are they obligated to reduce my mortgage payment thanks to having gotten rid of either PMI or getting a much better homeowner figure?
Mm-hmm.
That's my question.
Well, you can notify your mortgage company right away, Lynn. Typically, mortgage companies are required to analyze the escrow account once and sometimes twice a year. And so that could be affected sooner or later. Usually doesn't affect the payment right away, but hey, take a little time, save yourself a lot of money in the long run. Hopefully by the end of that year or even sooner, you would see a reflection in your lower payment.
Okay, I'll give that advice to our clients when we save them that
and
bundle.
Lynn, thank you for sponsoring Talk Shop, the networking group we talk about all the time. And how do we contact you, Lynn? You're with Aaron McDonald Insurance Agency.
I can get calls at 849-7101-901-849-7101.
All right, and you can find Lynn on my blog, jogarner.com. And it's that time, Kim, when we do the real estate tip of the week, and I actually have it. Want to talk about Fannie and Freddie. A lot of people in the past, they would say, hey, we're going to avoid mortgage insurance. We're going to do an 80% first mortgage, and we're going to do a little what's called a piggyback credit line on top of that, and then just put a little money down and not have to pay mortgage insurance. Well, Fannie and Freddie kind of got wise to that, and they have gone up significantly on their rate if you do a combination of a first and second mortgage. I did the numbers, Kim, on somebody who has high credit scores and using somebody like your company with a much lower rate on private mortgage insurance than what you'd get with traditional mortgage insurance companies. hands down, it's going to save that customer over the next, say, five-year projection more, thousands of dollars more, depending on the loan amount, going with a little PMI monthly amount rather than having to pay a higher rate over the entire term of the loan, over the entire loan amount. It's cheaper to go with a small monthly PMI than it is to try to do the piggyback thing because of the rate, you know, the higher rate and price that Fannie and Freddie's charging on those now. Yeah. So that's my tip of the week. Take a little extra time to have your lender break that out for you. I've got a few announcements this Wednesday, April 6th, 2016. Join other business people at Talk Shop to hear notable Memphis historian Jimmy Ogle. He's going to be presenting Selling Others on Memphis, Past and Present. Jimmy's got a wealth of fun stories about the past and even knows a lot about the present, you know, in the Memphis Memphis history. Talk Shop offers networking and education. It's free to anyone interested in real estate or business, and it's every Wednesday at the University of Phoenix, that's 65 Germantown Court, first floor, right across Germantown Parkway from the Ag Center. And for more information about Talk Shop, go to talkshoppe.com. Talk Shop events are free for the next 2 months, thanks to one of our many advertisers, Tim and Katie Gilliland of www.backuprx.com. Let them give you peace of mind about your data with cloud services, data backup and recovery plans. You can reach Katie and Tim at 901-507-6816. TalkShop.com and JoeGarner.com. Want to thank Kim Hummel of SauceMemphis.com for throwing some flavor on our online marketing. You can reach Kim for throwing some flavor on your marketing at SauceMemphis.com. Sauce, like hot sauce. For this podcast of Real Estate Mortgage Shop and more, go to JoeGarner.com. Call me. Let's make your plan, work your plan. If the deal works for you today, do it today. Want to thank our realtors and real estate pros for being part of our survey this week. Kevin Figg with Success Real Estate School, and Crylike, Pat Goldstein, Crylike, and Terry Murphy, who is a real estate lending coach, terrymurphy.com. Kim, I think you have an announcement.
I do, just for the lenders out there. We've got in a couple of weeks coming up here in Memphis at the Peabody Hotel, the Great River Mortgage Bankers Association is holding an annual conference. It's going to represent the states of Tennessee, Mississippi, Arkansas, and Missouri. Oh, I think we have almost 700 attendees lined up now. There's continuing ed available, great golf tournament on Wednesday. Ooh, if they haven't, yes, they want to get some golf in at Windyke Country Club, be a member for a day. Thursday's events are all day. Then Friday, we've got a little executive panel. Industry leaders are going to gather around and just sit in chairs and kind of talk about what keeps them up at night. Good stuff, Joe.
All right, good stuff. Well, got a couple of quotes real quick before we go off the air. From Lucille Harper, time is a great healer, but a poor beautician. And here's another one. There's never enough time to do it right. There's always enough time to do it over. Jack Bergman. And here's the last one. Time is money, especially when you're talking to a lawyer or buying a commercial. You've been listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I'm Joe Garner, your host. Would love to have you back next Saturday, and we'd love hanging out with you. JoeGarner.com. We'll see you again next Saturday.
Honey, your love's better than money in the bank.
Thank you for listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop Program, where we offer you solutions to your real estate and financing scenarios. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage professional. Catch this podcast and more at jogarner.com. ogarner.com. 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 ogarner.com.